All right, let's start today's class. Okay, so here you can see that we have our model space, and yesterday we have learned about UCS and WCS, how our AutoCAD works. Now, under these two coordinate system, we will know about our coordinate values. So we have two coordinates. That is, one is Cartesian coordinate and another one is polar coordinate. So if you are using Cartesian coordinate, in between Cartesian coordinate also has two types and polar coordinate also has two types. So Cartesian coordinate has like absolute Cartesian and relative Cartesian. So the Cartesian coordinate is when you calculate the value in respect of your x, y, and z, that is your Cartesian coordinate. And you have absolute Cartesian and you have relative Cartesian. So when you called the value as absolute Cartesian, when you calculate from the origin, and when I say origin in AutoCAD, that means UCS origin. Am I right? Right, so you are calculating the value from UCS origin, then the value is called absolute Cartesian, and you have another that is relative Cartesian. So relative Cartesian, that means you are calculating the value from the last point or the previous point, then it is called relative Cartesian. Okay, so now let me show you about these values. Now make sure that when you are inputting your values, make sure that right now at the beginning your dynamic input, that is your F12, and this is the symbol that is dynamic input. Okay, this is right now should be off. Okay, at the beginning, and why so, I'll tell you later. Now I will activate the line command with the L enter. Now let me place 0, 0, and right now this is the origin of our UCS, that is okay. And suppose you are creating your site plan, and for that you have all the northing and easting values, the coordinate values, and here you will be inserting those. So the values as per the world coordinate system, right? But here AutoCAD works according to UCS. But you don't have to worry because UCS right now aligned with your WCS. Here you can see. All right. In the last class, I have already covered this part. So you are already aware of that. So 0, 0, you can say we're getting at the WCS origin as well. All right. So the next point, if I press like 60, 60, and you press enter. So that is the sorry guys. So here you can see that I have placed two points. And this line connected between these two point. First point is 0, 0, and then second point is 60, 60. So this point is calculated from the origin, that is 60, 60. All right. So 60 is the x positive value and y positive value is also 60. Now the next point, if I type like 60, comma 120, enter. So this is the value 60,120, and that is also calculated from this origin. That is your absolute coordinate value, right? Now, about the relative coordinate, how you can enter the value for relative Cartesian coordinate. So for that, you have to put @ in the prefix. And let me type the same values. So as I mentioned that it will be calculating the value from the last point. So this is the last point, and I'm going to add my upcoming point. So the upcoming point's value will be calculated from the previous point or the last point added in AutoCAD. So here if I type @60,60. So now it will not count or calculate the value from this origin. It will calculate this value from this point. Okay. Or you can easily understand by this line that the last point will be the new origin for the calculation only. This is just for understanding. This is not actual true. This is just for understanding. So the upcoming point will be calculated from this point. So from this point, @ means it will calculate from this point, and from this point, the positive value of x, that is 60, and the y positive value is 60. It will take like this. Okay. So go for it @60,60, enter, and here you can see, right? Now, if I want a straight line at the same value, so here I have to put @. So here my x value will be 0, right? If I count from this point, there will be no x. It will go only towards the y positive direction. So y will be 0, comma, I know that the value is 60. And here it is. Okay, so this point is calculated from this point. This is the last point. Okay, so this is about your absolute Cartesian and relative Cartesian. Okay. So you understand about these two coordinates? Any question regarding these two coordinates? Hope you understand, right?
Yes, sir.
Great. Now let me thank you. Thank you, guys. Now let me talk about the polar coordinate system. Before I discuss about the polar coordinate, you have to keep in mind two things: that you have one initial angle. From that angle, your angle calculation will be started. And you have positive direction and negative direction for your angle calculation. Okay. So for that, let me draw something. Let me draw. I will tell you about how I'm drawing it, and you will understand how I drawn. Okay. And you can change the color if you want. Okay, so this is the direction. All right, this is the direction. Let me draw one arrow there. Mm. So this is the positive direction. Okay, this is the positive direction. Let me go the text value here, and let me change the text value to 250, enter, and this will be your positive value. Okay. Let me decrease this. Okay, so this is the positive direction, and let me copy this. And this is the negative direction. Okay. All right. So this thing you have to keep in mind, and this one, like, this is east. Okay, this side is east. Okay. All right. So this thing you have to keep in mind, that this is your initial angle, and that is the value, like, zero. Okay, sorry. Okay, And now, if you are going towards this direction, so then this one will be like minus, okay? So let me copy this one. And this one, this value will be like minus 90. This value will be same minus 180. And this value will be minus 270. Okay. And this can be 0 or 360. So this thing you have to keep in mind. All right. Now let me just hide them, right click, isolate and hide objects. Now let me go with any diagram there with a line. So if I place this here at this point, and for this polar coordinate also, I can place absolute and relative. Okay, if the value is calculated from the origin, that is absolute, and if it is calculated from the last point, so that is your relative, right? So that is the based on the origin calculation, based on the calculation, we have two types, that is absolute and relative. And let me tell you about the polar coordinate system. So about the polar coordinate system, it calculates the length of the line. So here you will not place any coordinate point. Here from the last point or from the first point, you will be defining the length of the line and the angle where it will be placed in between your 360 degree. So it's like the radius you are defining, the radius, that is the length, okay? The length of your line you are defining. And from that, you are defining the angle, okay? And it may be calculated from the origin, it may be calculated from the last point, okay? So now let me place them in object isolation. Okay. Now let me have a line here. Okay. So now let me have this. And okay. So let me have. So I have placed one point randomly, one point here. So from this point, if I need to calculate all my values, the length and the angle, then I'll be placing at the rate. I'll be taking relative polar coordinate at the rate, and then the length 250, and then less than. The symbol will be less than to shift the value to angle, and then you place like, let me place with 0 degree. Okay. So from this point, this is the direction for 0, right? If you don't understand, place this one. And how I am selecting this blue window and this green window, I'm coming on that part later. Let me go for copy. And here if you place, so this is the point from this point everything is calculated. So from this point I have the length, that is 250, and the angle is 0, right? Now let me undo this. Now from this point I'll be continuing, so I'll be placing in this direction, so it will be like I'll be maintaining a 30 degree angle in between these two line, and all my line will have the same length, that is 250. Okay, so if I want to maintain this 30 degree, right, the 30 degree, so my initial angle is 0. So my initial angle is 0. So this direction to this direction will be 180, and then 30. So I have to provide 210 angle, right? So at the rate 250 less than 210, enter. Okay, so it's maintaining, now it's maintaining the angle 30 degree in between this two line, right? But I cannot place 30 degree, because if I input the value 30 degree in the angle, so it will be placed here, right? So here I have to place angle value that will be calculated from the east, right? So here if I place this one, so from this point it is calculated. Now here you can see that from the east, this is the value 210, and it's maintaining like this. Okay, I hope you understand. If you find anything, any doubt, you can interrupt in between and you can ask me the question. All right, so let me continue here. So from this, let me have it. So from this also, it will make like 120. Okay, in between this, I will have 30 degree. So this is my zero and this will be 120. Okay, so at the rate 250 is then 120, enter. Okay, so for this one, let me maintain 60 degree angle. Okay, so now let me just rotate this. So from this position, if I want to rotate, okay, so for this rotate option here, I'm not adding any polar coordinate here, I'm just rotating. Okay, so you choose this icon, rotate, or arrow is the command, and after that, let me show you. You select rotate or arrow, enter, then you select this object. The object selection is done, then you specify, enter. Then you choose the base point. This is the base point for your rotation, and this will be the initial angle. Okay, then you will be giving the angle value, so that will be 30 in the positive direction. So this is the positive direction, right? Anti-clockwise direction is the positive direction, or counterclockwise direction is the positive direction, and clockwise direction is the negative direction. So 30 degree more. And here I have. Okay, so let's maintain 60 degree angle and with the same length. So here I need to maintain 60 degree with this line. So the length is 250. And here you can see that I have, this is, if I calculate this direction 0, then this 90, this 180, then 180 plus 60, right? Easy calculation. So less than 240, enter, and here I have, right? And again I had to draw this line with the same length. So this is my 0 degree, 90 degree, and 180 degree. So at the rate 250 less than 180 degree, enter. Okay, and then next, at the rate 250 less than 300.
Hello, sir.
Hello. Yes.
Sir, could you please tell me that how you are managing the angles, like the way you have managed 240 for that line?
Yeah, right. So let me place this each and every point. Okay, so it will be difficult. Let me go with one. Let me go with the one copy. And here if I go and place, so from this point, everything will be calculated, right? From this point, your length will be there. So length, this length 250, it can be placed in this direction, it can be placed in any direction in between your 360 degree, right? So here I have to maintain a 60 degree in bit with this. I have to maintain a relation with this line, that is 60 degree angle. So here you can see that this is the initial angle. So from this east, your angle will be calculated in the positive direction. That you have to keep in mind. This is the thing. So you calculate that this is the direction 180, and then how much angle you need more. Okay, so right now this is 270. Okay, this is 270, and you need to maintain 60 degree with this line, with this line, right? So how much you remaining? 60 degree here, right? If you calculate, you can see 60 degree more. So if it is not even clear right now, so you can see this is one, and you can draw this line, you can extend this line here, and you know that here also 60 degree is maintained. So this is 60 degree and this is 60 degree. You know this rule, right? You know this?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes. So this is 60 degree, right? And then you know this is your 270, right? Mm-hmm. And this to this is your 90 degree. So this
is
60 and this is 30.
Yes.
And this way you got this, right?
Okay.
Yeah.
But then too, sir, I want to ask that how we will calculate. It means if I don't know all these things, I mean this circle, if I don't want to draw this circle, then how will I calculate the 60 degree angle?
Yeah, here I know the diagram, so that's why I'm drawing it. So
yes, sir.
You a diagram will be given where like this angle will be provided. Here you have to maintain this gap with this angle particular, like 45 or 60 degree, and then you will find out. Okay, so I will explain more with more diagrams, and
okay, sir.
In the next diagram, I will be showing you the proper diagram. Okay.
So for all the practical, for all the practical applications, we'll be provided with the diagram of the reference, no?
Yes. Right.
Okay, sir. Okay, thank you, sir.
Yes. All right, so like this, I'm completing it. So for the other half, I can mirror it. No need to place all this and waste your time. Just you can mirror this. So you go with this mirror. You mirror this. So for that, you click on this mirror, or you can type MI as the command. You select it, and when your selection is completed, you press enter, and then you specify your mirror axis. So for that, you need to specify two points. This is my first point and this is my second point, and that is completed. And after that, it's asking you want to erase your source object. So this is my source object. Do you want to erase that? No, I don't want to erase. So if you erase your source object, you will get the mirror effect, your symmetrical object only. So if you need results like that, so you can go for yes. I need the both, so I'll go for no. And I have it. Okay. So you may have any kind of site plan where you will be provided with northing easting values and your angles and all that. So for that, you can choose this coordinate method to draw that diagram. So for that, let me just show you. You go to UN units, enter here, and here you can see that you have this angle type. So the decimal degrees, if you have any diagram where you have to place radian values or any surveyor units with this nodding is thing. Okay, so that you can choose, and you will be placing with this with these values. And about the direction, here you can see that the base angle is east, so this is the default. You can change it, but this is the initial. And we know that as per our WCS, this is the initial. Okay, so you know that as per this WCS, this is the base angle, this is the initial angle, and you click on OK. All right, so you can type the values here, you can change it. Okay, all right, so this is your two coordinate values, and I'll show you with the diagram there. Let me just search it. Let me quickly search for it. Give me a second, guys. Let me quickly search for it. Okay, about that diagram, I have shared in the WhatsApp. Let me know that you have received that diagram.
Yes, I got it.
Okay, so now let me go with that diagram here. Okay, now I hope you will understand. Now with that line, so here you can see that I have two coordinate values, right? I have two coordinate values, that is my absolute Cartesian value. Okay, so let's go for it, and here let me just type L enter, and my first value is 1, 1, enter. Okay, that is my first value, 1, 1, and about the second value, so that will be 4.1, 1, enter, and here I have this horizontal line, and another that is 4.5, 2.2, right? And here I have, and about the next line, I have only the length. So how can I place it? I can give at the rate. So that at the rate means it will be calculated from this point, right? So at the rate, what is the value? 2.3. And where it will be placed? 2.3 can be placed in 90 degree, 2.3 can be placed at a 180 degree direction. So 2.3, I can see that it is placed in this direction towards the right side. So that is 0 degree. Any doubt about this angle? No, right? @0, enter. And about the next. So here you see that the previous line, I have to maintain 150 degree. So I know that this is the value from the east is 180 degree. So I have to place towards 30 degree direction. Then it can maintain 150. So it is clear, right? So what is the value? 1.4. 1.4 @ 30 degree, right? And about the next. So the next is placed vertically. So we can place it @ 2.1 less than 90, enter. And about the next one, so it will be placed 120 degree. So from 0, it will be placed at 120 degree so that it will be maintaining 150 with this vertical line. Right? Any doubt? @ 1.6 less than 120, enter. Right, and here you can place. So let me quickly place with 1.3. So you can place easily with your mouse if you have on this ortho mode. So this is to maintain a straight line.
So ortho can't you maintain 150 degree from internal lines?
Yeah, we can do that. We can do like we can maintain with this functional keys we have. I'll show you that also.
Okay,
I'll show you that also. Yeah. So now let me just show you that how you can maintain any straight line with this ortho mode. So the functional key is F8. So you can either activate with F8 or this is the symbol to activate ortho mode. So this function will maintain straight line. So how it maintain? It restricts your crosshair between 0 degree, 90 degree, 180 and 270. So here I need, so in this direction, just place your crosshair and then just put the value 1.3 and enter. And you got it. And in this direction also, place your mouse, crosshair, and then type the value 1.4 and press enter. And now it will, you have to maintain 45 degree with this. So you have to calculate from the east what will be the value, right? So @ 2.2 less than 90 plus 45, that is 135, enter. Okay. And then here one, enter. And here you need to go with 45 degrees, so 180 plus 45, right? @ 1.5 less than 225, that is my angle, enter. And here one, enter. And here you need to maintain 60 degree, so you will be providing @ length, that is 2.3, then less than angle value. That will be your .300, right? The angle value will be .300, right? Enter. And then you can close it or you can put the value. So if you close it, I have already mentioned that from the last point to the first point, it will close the segment.
Hello?
Yes.
Sir. Can we write minus 60 instead of 300?
Yeah, definitely. Definitely you can do that. Okay. So I'm going with the positive values so that you can understand the better. Okay. Here @ the value. If it is provided the length, then you can put the value or you can just simply close it. All right, so here you have done this. Okay, so you can done this with the polar tracking. Here we have polar tracking. So this will track the angle. Okay, so this will track the angle. You can choose. Now you can see that we have these values because in the unit section I have provided this surveyor unit. So right now I don't need surveyor units, I need decimal degrees, and you can click OK, and now you can see. Okay, so what kind of angle you need, like 30 degree increment or 15 degree incremental angle. So here you have the list. Here you have the list. From this list you can choose, or you can go to tracking settings. So these are your incremental angle. So you can choose any incremental angle like 15 degree. So it will first highlight, or it will track 0 degree, and then incremental angle will be 15, and then 30, then 45. So 15's increment. Okay, and here you can add any angle, like go for new, and you can add like 30.75, this kind of angle you can add. All right, so that can be added here, like this you can add. All right, so this will be added. You can click on OK, and here you can find out that 31. So why this is 31 showing? Because like if you go to that unit, here you see that the precision is set to 0 only. So that's why. So if you increase this and click on OK, and here you can see 30.75, right? So let me just set to units. I don't need to see that much. That is fine. Click on OK, and here you can see. OK, so you can choose this one. For this purpose, I need this one. So this is checked. OK, and you click on this. So this is right now active. So when this polar tracking active, this polar tracking function is active right now, you cannot active ortho mode, right? Because I have told you that ortho mode will restrict your crosshair in between 0, 90, 180 and 270. So it cannot be possible to track another angle if you have ortho mode on, right? Now let me go with that. So with the same value, if I go with the same value, so for that, let me just change the position with the move. I'll come on this part, move, copy, and this. Okay. So I have mentioned about rotate and mirror. Now let me go with that. Okay. So the first point is 1, 1, enter. And the second point is your 4.1, 1, enter. And the next point is 4.5, 2.2, right? And here you can see it's like the same. It's tracking the 0 degree and placing your crosshair towards this direction. You just put the value 2.3. Enter. Okay, and here you need to track your 30 degree. You need to track 30 degree. So here you are tracking this 30 degree. Place your crosshair towards this direction and you place the value 1.4 and enter. And again, you place your crosshair towards 90 degree and you place the value, the length of your line 2.1, and so on. You can do this, right? So this way you can have it 1.6. Okay, like this you can have. All right. I hope it is clear to everyone.
Hello.
Yeah, hello.
So can't you just put 150 degree straight away?
In this 150 degree direction, right? So yes, this sir. This is not 150 degree. It's maintaining the 150 degree with this line. But
yes, sir.
The angle is calculated from the east. So from the east, it is not 150 degree.
Okay. So for the east, can't we do this directly? I mean, why go to the east direction and just means we, so have, we can just
you
enter
see
the,
that every time you have to change the direction then.
Yes, that is the thing.
Right. So we can do that. So we need to fix one direction, and as per that, it will be easy.
Okay, sir. So, so this means that it's a calculated one, but precise.
Yeah, right.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Okay. So let me share another diagram. That will be the task for you guys. Okay, so this one will be the task. All right. I hope it is clear to everyone about the today's class.
Yes, sir.
And one more thing that, guys, from the next class, I'll not be sharing in WhatsApp. So for that, please, please share your email addresses in WhatsApp group. In the WhatsApp group, please share all of your email addresses. So I'll be adding you guys in this Microsoft team. I'll be creating a group in this Microsoft team, and their proper channels will be there. There I'll be adding all the tasks and all the informations. All right. So
okay, sir.
Okay. Start sharing your email addresses. All right. Thank you, guys. Thank you for today.